नमस्कार, ग्रेट मैन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल की ऑनलाइन क्लासेस में मैं आपका स्वागत करता हूँ। कोविड-19 महामारी के इस दौर में मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि आपका परिवार पूरी तरह सुरक्षित है, स्वस्थ है और बच्चों ने लॉकडाउन में बहुत एंजॉय किया। अब मैं आपका सपोर्ट चाहता हूँ इस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस में। बच्चों की शिक्षा को हम अब स्टार्ट करते हैं और बहुत ही जल्द जो भी आपका बैकलॉग है हम उसको क्लियर भी करेंगे और एक नए तरीके से आपकी शिक्षा अब स्टार्ट होने वाली है। पेरेंट्स का हमें पूरा सपोर्ट चाहिए। आप लोग पिछले 10 सालों से लगातार हमें सपोर्ट करते आए हैं और मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि अगर हम और आप मिलकर चाहेंगे तो बच्चों की शिक्षा का कोई नुकसान नहीं होने वाला है और हमें और आपको मिलकर अब एक रीस्टार्ट करना है। नाउ लेट्स रीस्टार्ट। बेस्ट ऑफ लक। नमस्कार। ऑल ऑफ अस थैंकफुल ऑल द कोविड वॉरियर्स। यस, इट वाज अ वेरी अनसर्टेन सिचुएशन। देयर वाज अ बिग प्रॉब्लम बट नो सॉल्यूशन, गेट नो सॉल्यूशन। So, they did their duty very well and we are all proud of them and we'll be supporting them in all our ways. So now, get back to studies because that's your challenge. You have to face it, be prepared. Now, as far as time is changing, we have to change the way the studies were going. And yes, you also need to change. We have to be more progressive, and that's why I am here with you to teach you in the same manner I am always there to teach you. Okay, so let's start with our chapter, Constitution. Okay, I am hopeful you're having the books. If you're not having the books, you can just download it from the CBSC Diksha and you can get all the notes also. For examinations, I'll be giving you some separate PDF files. Those files will have some notes for you, some important questions also, and answers. So let's start with the topic and the first chapter, the Constitution. What is the Constitution? Anything you know about it? No? Okay. Like our home, we have made some rules for our country. Do we have some rules? Yes. For our home, do we have some rules? Yes. Now, for you, if I say ki you are a citizen of this country, the same way you are a member of your family, there are certain rules within our family, for our home. Yes, there are. For example, the earning member of a family. Yes, your father. Maybe some of the mothers also are working and they are contributing for your welfare. Yes, they are the government. Yes, they are making rules for you. What are the rules for you? You have to get up early, take bath. You have to take breakfast. Then you should do or you should study. When the lockdown was not there, you were coming to school daily. So these are the rules set for you. The same way, the constitution is a rule book for our whole country, and it defines the duty of every single person, be it government or citizen. The government, or we can say the people who are making rule for us, there are certain things which is defined in the constitution for them. There are certain rules which is defined in the constitution, who will make the rules. And as far as our constitution is concerned, we have followed democracy as the principle, and democracy can be simply defined as the government will be by the people, the government will work for the people, and the government will be formed of the people. Okay? The government by the people, for the people, of the people. Okay? And they will make rules for us. As well as the constitution has made, or the makers of this constitution were well aware of how our country will be run. So they have defined the rules for the government also, for the citizens also. If we are saying that there are rules defined for government as well as citizens, the same way there are certain freedom given to the citizens also. It is not like that you are always under some rules. It is also defined that there are certain freedoms which every citizen enjoy. Those freedoms are called fundamental rights. There are duties also which everybody should do. They are fundamental duties. So this way I can simply say, like our home, there are rules for our home, there are rules for this country. The earning member or the welfare in our home, the welfare or the earning is taken care by our parents. The same way, the welfare of the people, how the economy will run, and how the citizen will be provided good facilities is taken care by the government. So I can simply say it is a rule book which defines the duty of every single authority of this country as well as the citizen. So you can just understand in this way, constitution is something which defines the duty, the responsibility, the authority, as well as the freedom of the citizen, the rules which are there, the duties of the citizen. It combines everything. Like our home, the constitution is the rule book of our country. Okay, so you can just read the first chapter, and the next topic I'll teach you with a different video. First of all, let us see, like we were discussing, ki it's a rule book. How this country will be governed? So there are different type of governance. Like I told you, like our home, there are some rules. So for different countries, there is a different way of governance. And how many type of governance you know? Earlier, we know that there were
kingdoms. There were kingdoms. Do we still see some kingdoms? Yes, there are kingdoms. They are called monarchy. What they are called? Monarchy. Okay? Then there is a way of governance which is called democracy. It can be a elected democracy. Then in that elected democracy, there is a written constitution. There can be a democracy also with a unwritten constitution. I think the example, if you ask me, you just search for it, Israel is a country which is having a democratic system, but still it don't have a constitution. Okay, you can just cross verify it, because there are a lot of information which is coming and rules are changing frequently. So I'll say ki you just cross check it. Secondly, India, a democratic country, elected government, written constitution. You can just see the oldest constitution, written constitution, America. America got its independent way back in the year 1783, and 1786 the constitution, it's a very small constitution, but there was a constitution. The constitution was adapted, or the constitution came into application from the year 1789. So America is a country where the oldest written constitution is applicable. Now there is another system, like you can say a federal system, or you can say a centrally controlled system. Federal system means there is a government where a center and a state is existing together. There are separate rules for center and there are separate rules for state, and they are coordinating with each other. There are specific rules defined for center, there are specific rules defined for the state in the same constitution. So we have seen there are different type of governance models which are being adapted by different countries. One, monarchy. Then we see democracy. There are some military rules also. Military rules. It means the country is controlled by a specific commander, military head. In some countries, it is the elected representative, or they are forcefully elected. They have made rules for themselves and they got elected forcefully. So the governance model of rule making, the government way of running the government is different, and we have seen a lot of details are available in our books also, and if you want to search, you can search it online also. As far as Indian constitution is concerned, it was a very long exercise and there were a lot of people involved in making our constitution. You can see ki we have adopted lot of good things from different countries, but you can just see the impact of UK, United Kingdom, who was ruling over us, is very high, especially if we see the parliamentary form of government. In India, we have a parliamentary form of government with two houses, the upper house, like they have House of Commons and House of Lord. We have Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. You have heard these words? I hope you have heard these words. We elect representatives, like we have Member of पार्लियामेंट इलेक्टेड और लोकसभा दैट इज हाउस ऑफ कॉमन्स लाइक यूनाइटेड किंगडम. वी हैव मेंबर्स इन राज्यसभा, दे आर इनडायरेक्टली इलेक्टेड एंड इट इज लाइक हाउस ऑफ लॉर्ड्स. वी हैव प्राइम मिनिस्टर हु इज द हेड ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, ही इज द हेड ऑफ आर कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स एंड ही इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू रन दिस कंट्री. इन आर स्टेट वी हैव चीफ मिनिस्टर हु इज द हेड ऑफ द स्टेट, रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू रन द स्टेट एंड वी हैव लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज. सो ही इज द लीडर ऑफ द लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली एंड वी इलेक्ट मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज ऑल्सो नोन एज विधायक. वी इलेक्ट मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज. ओके, सो फॉर स्टेट वी हैव चीफ मिनिस्टर एज द हेड ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. फॉर आर सेंट्रल वी हैव मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट, दे इलेक्ट देयर लीडर हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू रन द गवर्नमेंट एंड ही इज नोन एज प्राइम मिनिस्टर. सो इन आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वी सी द रोल्स ऑफ एवरीबडी इज वेल डिफाइंड. Now we have to see or we will study about the history of our constitution. We will study about the function of our constitution. We will study about different constitution which is adopted by the different countries. What is the difference or the way of government, how the government are running or the way of governance. Okay. So, you just open the book and read. There are four functions given in your book about our Indian constitution. So, what are the four functions of our constitution? Just go through it, then I'll explain one by one. Okay, so now open the book and just read the first function of our constitution.